Let's see if we can graph the linear equation 3x minus 2y equals 8 by plotting points. Now, if you've already watched our video on how to graph linear equations by plotting points, you'll remember that the first step that we need to do is isolate this y, is to solve for y first. So let's take 3x minus 2y equals 8, and let's try to isolate this y on the left-hand side by itself. So the first thing I think we'd do is subtract this 3x over here to the right, and we'd have negative 2y equals minus 3x plus 8. And the last step is we're going to need to get rid of this negative 2, this being multiplied times y. So we'll divide the left side by negative 2 and the entire right-hand side by negative 2 as well. So once these cancel, the negative 2's on the left-hand side, we'll get y equals this big ugly fraction. Now, one thing I notice is because there's addition in the numerator and we're dividing by only a single term, we can actually break this apart into two separate fractions, which will probably look a lot better. So we'll take negative 3x divided by negative 2. Plus 8 divided by negative 2. And that just looks a little bit cleaner. Now, I do see one last thing I think we can do as well. These negatives, the negative 3x divided by negative 2, those negatives will cancel and we'll get 3 halves x, and then minus 8 divided by 2, which is 4. This minus will get pulled out in front of the fraction and become a minus 8 divided by 2, which is 4. So this is the form of the equation that I would probably use if I were to graph by plotting points. So once we have this equation solved for y, where do we go from there? Well, now it's time to make our xy table. And what this is going to give us is a list of ordered pairs of points that are on the graph of this equation. And once we have those points and once we see how they're lining up in a straight line, we'll simply connect the dots with a line, and that'll be the graph of our linear equation. Now, typically what we do when we're choosing x values, most of the time we'll just choose minus 2 to 2. That's a good standard default choice for picking x values. But in this particular example, I don't think that's really the best idea. We can certainly do it and we would get the right answer and we would get the right graph. But instead, I think I'm going to stay away from that for this reason. Notice if you plugged in negative 2, 0, or 2, you'd be fine. Because look at when you plug in for x right here, all of these terms are being divided by 2. And I can divide negative 2 by 2 because it's an even number and the 2's will cancel. If you plug in 0, anything times 0 is 0, so that works out well. And if you plugged in 2, 3 halves times 2 also works out well. So those work out pretty well. But if you were to plug in minus 1 or 1, you would get expressions like 3 halves minus 4 or negative 3 halves minus 4, which is going to lead you to a y value that has fractions. Now, that's not the end of the world. That's okay. But if I can avoid fractions, especially when I'm having to plot them as points and whatnot, I think I would rather avoid that. So here's what I think I'm going to do instead. In my XY table, I'm going to only choose X's that are even numbers. You can certainly pick ones that aren't, but I think I'm going to pick X's that are even because I know that I'm going to have to plug in this X and it's going to be divided by 2, and I would prefer if X was even. So maybe let's just use a smaller table this time. Maybe let's just do negative 2, 0, and 2 only, because I think that'll be sufficient. Typically, you want at least 3, and so we're going a little bit on the short side. But if you want to pick an additional number, I'll tell you what, let's do one more. Let's do negative 2, 0, let's do 2 and 4. Because typically we want at least 4 values just to be on the safe side. So let's take these x's, we'll plug them in, and we'll see the y values that we get out of the function. If you plug in negative 2, negative 3 halves times negative 2 3 halves times negative 2 minus 4. These 2's would cancel, and you get negative 3 minus 4, which is negative 7. All right, and then we'll plug in a 0. And I don't think I'm going to write all these down. I think we can just look at most of these. 3 halves times 0 is 0. 0 minus 4 is negative 4. If we plug in a 2, 3 halves times 2 would be 3. 3 minus 4 makes negative 1. And last one, 3 halves times 4, the 4 and the 2 reduce, and you get 6. 6 minus 4 makes 2. So these are a few points that are on the graph of this linear equation. These are all x, y ordered pairs that we can plot. So let's do that next. Let's plot all these points. Here we've got negative 2, comma, negative 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. This is almost going off my screen. Maybe something like that. And then 0, comma, negative 4. Negative 1, 2, 3, here's negative 4. Then we'll get 2, comma, negative 1. And you see these are starting to line up in a straight line. And last one, 1, 2, 3, 4, comma, 1, 2, be somewhere right about here. Okay, and sure enough, these points line up in a straight line. So I can now see what the graph of this linear equation looks like. I'll pick a point, or pick a line through these points rather. So I'll start my line maybe like right here, make it go through all those points. And maybe my points aren't absolutely perfect, but you definitely get the idea behind what this line looks like. And so this is a graph of this linear equation. So just to recap, what we do when we graph by plotting points is you solve the equation for y, and then that makes it easier to pick your points or plug in your x values in the xy table. You plot the points, and then you connect the dots using a line.